Chancellor, post-Brexit divisions remain over Northern Ireland. Can you envisage any situation where the text of the protocol might be changed in future, or even EU law altered in order to make the situation on the ground easier? And could you explain whether Britons who have had both vaccinations should be expect to be able to come to Germany, to the wider European Union this summer? Prime Minister, how did those discussions on travel go, particularly in light of the worrying news this morning that some people who are double jabbed with AstraZeneca have discovered that they've been given the wrong batch? The Serum Institute from India batches aren't licensed for use across the EU, meaning some people could be turned away even though they're double jabbed at the EU border. And I just wanted to finally ask you about Batley and Spen. The Conservative campaign rather stood by the sidelines, hoping George Galloway's divisive campaign might split the Labour vote and you would storm to victory. That didn't happen. Did you deserve to lose? Do you feel a bit grubby this lunchtime?
Well, of course, we talked about the implementation of the Northern Ireland Protocol. I personally believe that on the basis of this protocol and within the framework of how it was negotiated, we can find pragmatic solutions that, on the one hand, maintain the integrity of the single market, but that will also, on the other hand, contribute to creating acceptable solutions for the people. It is obviously understandable that this was prolonged, and I think it's a good thing that this was prolonged for another few months, and I think it should be possible for all of us to come to a pragmatic solution within this grace period. And I think I'm optimistic that this can happen. Now, secondly, we have adopted certain protective measures when we were not as yet so familiar with the Delta variant. We now see that the share of those of the Delta variant in Germany is increasing very rapidly. As you know, we're reviewing continuously our travel restrictions, and we think that in a foreseeable future, those who have received double jabs will then, according to our classification, and now right now Britain obviously is a high incidence area, will be able to travel again without having to go into quarantine. We would like to encourage people to have be vaccinated in the beginning. We didn't have that much experience with this variant, but we're dealing with it, and we are approaching this in this spirit that I outlined right now, and this variant is actually spreading very quickly in Germany too. But let me point out yet again, it's not only Germany that imposes travel restrictions. The United Kingdom too has done quite a lot in order to protect its own citizens, and that is a continuous learning process that we undergo, is it not? We have to adjust it time and again to the most recent developments. Those were the two answers I could give.
Thanks very much, Sam. And you'll have heard what Chancellor Merkel just said about the German process and where they are on double jabs. And I think that's great, and that's right. It sounds as though progress is being made. And I think that Angela is also right to point out that the UK, we also have very tough restrictions. I mean, restrictions on people coming from Germany at the present time. And that's quite right. You'd expect us to have the toughest possible measures to stop the disease arriving in this country. On your question about the Serum Institute of India and the AstraZeneca vaccinations, I see no reason at all why the MHRA approved vaccines should not be recognised as part of the vaccine passports. And I'm very confident that that will not prove to be a problem. On your point about Batley and Spen, I would say that actually we fought an incredibly positive, Brian Stevenson fought an incredibly positive campaign, and all things considered did very well to reduce a long-standing Labour majority, more than several decades old, to only 323, with what I think, if I'm not mistaken, was the biggest swing in favour, the third biggest swing in favour of the government since the war. So I think that it was positive, and he Ryan fought on fighting crime, getting more police out on the street, and getting investment into Batley and Spen and across West Yorkshire, and that's what we're going to continue